dreadlocks.
Dreadlocks are good. Oh, it's cold. No, it's not.
Can we hurry up, please?
Thank you.
Hurry.
I know you!
Can I help you?
Oh, you're Ticket Booth Betty, aren't you?
What movie would you like?
I know you. You look so familiar. Don't pull my leg. Don't pull my leg. I know you.
What movie would you like?
Let's see. How about that, those fried green tomatoes? I'm kind of hungry.
It'll be $5.
Okay, I came with him. He's going to pay for it.
Okay. Can I help you?
Yeah, I want for final analysis.
Okay, it's going to be $10.
$10?
Ticket, please.
Hello, you're Ticket Taker Tim.
Name's Vicente. I'm not Ticket here.
Ooh, they must have spelled it wrong.
You're
a double agent.
Give me a ticket.
Okay. But I know you.
It's right that way.
I know you.
A large popcorn and two medium cokes.
Vice President, aren't you?
No.
Yes, you are. You're him. I know you. Bill Frazier. You were once the world boxing champion of the world. And you used to be tennis player champion 1942. I know you. Don't pull my leg. I know him. I know him. He was a friend of my dad.
Excuse me, sir. I'm sorry if we have to leave. You're making too much noise.
But
I'm sorry. There's nothing else I can do. Come on.
But wait a minute. It wasn't me. It was him. It was him. I wouldn't him.
What did he give you last year?
I know him. He was my dad's friend back in the late 70s. They used to disco together. Mm-hmm. Sure did. John Travolta's his name. Mm-hmm. Sure was. That was him.
Oh, wait! It was the other guy! It wasn't me! I didn't do anything!
Let me tell you something. When you've been cops this long, you are not fit for anything else.
We're looking for some new career challenges.
Yeah, something with a future. Show me another career they let you shoot. Give us some money.
You're mugging us? I don't believe it.
You better believe it or you did.
Oh, come on, let us keep the driver's licenses and the snapshot.
And our badges. I can't believe that you missed all six shots.
A riot broke out this evening in a local theater. It was business as usual at the Buddy-Rama Cinema 6 when patrons began beating one another and using professional wrestling moves. Police suspect that the movie the patrons were watching contained subliminal messages that caused the riot. The management of the theater claims to know nothing about the incident and police have no suspects. More after this.
Stop! 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 Mouse, what do you think you're doing? Pal, you were all over the place. You gave me too much headroom. You're sleeping on the job. You're coming in here late. I own you, Mouse. Now, just get the hell out of my sight. Get the hell out of here. I don't want to see you again today.
Way to go, pal.
Yo, this is a test.
Master, I still have to starch around thy shirts. It's too
last
much.
Last time
never
on
finish.
Bad Kung Fu Theater,
well, yeah.
After receiving a letter from his brother, Raunchy Poo Poo found Master Ding Pong and told him his brother had been killed by the Wang Chung clan. Ding Pong, Raunchy Poo Poo, and the other disciples began their training so that they could protect the brown stained dragon. But on their way to pick up Ding Pong's laundry, Soul Chop and Raunchy Poo Poo were killed by the Wang Chung ninja. Luckily, Master Pong was there to save Slum Lee Cho's life and to kill the Wang Chung ninja. We now continue with Stinky Poo Poo and the seven disciples of the brown stained dragon.